In the previous session, we discussed about creating an MVC core application and the basic infrastructure of MVC application. Now, in this session, we are going to learn how do we start up with that application, how we add a controller, how we add the models, views, step by step we will discuss. So we know the basic architecture of MVC. In the previous videos, we discussed about what is MVC, how MVC request flow works. If you are new to this video, please go through that previous videos where we discussed about the flow of MVC. Now, according to that flow, the client request will come to a controller, so which will process the request. And according to the request, it will handle communication with model and view. So what we are going to create now is a controller. Technically, what is a controller? Already we discussed about that. At this moment, we are looking at controller as a C# class. It's a C# class which contains the application specific logic and that handles the overall communication in MVC framework with integration with model and the views. So what is a controller technically? It is a C# class that contains set of methods that respond to client request. So how do we create a controller class and configure a controller class? Let's take a look about that. Actually, you can create a controller in two different ways. MVC core provides scaffolding. By using scaffolding, you can create a controller. Scaffolding is nothing but it is a technique where the code and UI is generated according to your requirements. So you tell about your requirements, it will generate all the code and manipulate the code for you. And manually, you can add a controller in a basic class type technique. Let's see the two ways how we can add a controller in MVC core application. So technically, we know that controller is a class. That means adding a controller is nothing but adding a class. So right click on the controllers folder and go to the option add and select add class. And we are giving a name for the controller class. And any name for the controller class, I am giving the name as some products. And as per the rules of controller, every controller class must have the suffix controller. We are using the suffix controller. So products controller is a class. Now just add. It is an ordinary C# class, but still it doesn't have a controller behavior. How you can give a controller behavior for this class? By implementing the controller base class. And for that, we need to import a namespace using microsoft.asp.net core.mvc. This is the library for MVC core. ASP.NET MVC core base library is microsoft.asp.net core.mvc. After importing this library, you can access the controller base class, and our controller products controller have to inherit the controller base class, the controller base class. So now it is a controller. So technically, we created a controller in MVC core environment. So the controller is ready to handle the interactions. But this controller is currently empty and we added the controller in a manual way. Let's see how to add a controller by using scaffolding techniques. How do we add controller by using scaffold techniques? So for that, first right click on controller and go to add controller. In this, you have to choose the scaffold template, empty MVC controller. There are a lot of scaffolds available. We have an empty, we have controller with read-write actions, we have controller with web API, web API OData. Various occasions, we need various controllers. Currently, we need just an empty controller. So let's select this empty MVC controller. And any name for the controller, I will give categories, the name for the controller. And let's click on add. So it's added. So you can observe that it is scaffolding. Scaffolding is nothing but it will identify all the dependencies that are required to add a controller. It will import the dependencies, install those dependencies, and it will wire up all the logic that is required for a controller. So you have to just start working with your controller. And you can see that this controller is added through scaffolding and it contains a predefined logic wired up. Now you can see the controller is ready and you can observe that here it imported the namespace Microsoft ASP.NET Core MVC and it is implementing the controller and it have some actions. Actions we will see later, how do we deal with them. But initially a controller is added into your project. Now we have two techniques of adding controller manually as a class and implement everything and by using scaffold techniques. That's how we configure and create the controllers. Now in the next level, we have to learn how do we define methods in a controller. That we will discuss in the next session. Thank you.